Hi guys, it's your favorite YouTuber again, Danny Solari, and you're watching DSL Learning Finance. Whoa. In the stock market, you have takeovers and you have mergers. Do you guys know what they're about? Want to find out? You know what to do, keep watching. First off, let me start explaining what a takeover and a merger is. So with a takeover, you have two roles. So you have a target company. This is otherwise known as a suitor company. This is the company that's bought. And from the other perspective, you have a bidder company or offeror company. Those are the two names. So the bidder company is the company that does the buying. So it makes more sense for the bidder company to be massively bigger than the target company because obviously it's trying to buy it. And with a takeover, you have one company, Company A, that's trying to buy Company B. There was a news release earlier on this year about Apple trying to acquire Disney. So that's a good example of a takeover company because Apple was actually trying to buy out Disney. So you have one company that's bigger than the other. Apple's massive. You have one company that's bigger than the other, trying to buy out and somehow, some way, trying to benefit themselves by buying it out. And clearly it would have been an official takeover if Apple had bought Disney. A perfect example of a merger company is the company ExxonMobil. So I actually recently found this out. Exxon used to be a separate oil and gas company in America. Mobil used to be a separate oil and gas company in America. But obviously we know it now as ExxonMobil because they actually joined forces in the late 1990s. And as you can see, ExxonMobil's definitely top 10 biggest companies in the world. So yeah, you can see the impact of takeover companies, and you can also see the impact of merging companies together as well. Cool, so now you guys know what a takeover and a merger is. I'm gonna particularly focus on a takeover because takeover is a bit more interesting. Now you have two types of takeovers. There's the friendly takeover. This is where you have the bidder company and the target company, and they see eye to eye in the sense of they are in cohesive agreement with one another. So the directors of the target company and the directors of the bidder company, they're both on the same page. You even have directors from the target company advising their shareholders to approve of the takeover, basically. So in regards to a friendly takeover, that's good because everyone sort of agrees with one another. But in life, all the good things tend to be boring, and the much more interesting things tend to be the bad news. Which brings me on to a second type of takeover, and that's called a hostile takeover. This is where you have the target company's directors say, no, we don't want to be bought out by the bidder company. And you even have the directors on the target company advising their shareholders to refuse agreeing with, obviously, the bidder trying to buy out the company. So, yeah. And that's a bit more interesting because of the dynamics between the target company, the bidder company, and the shareholders. Because ultimately, a majority of people that own the target company is the shareholders. So what you have is an interesting dynamic between the directors trying to advise their shareholders, okay, don't give in to the bidder company, stay with us, we're trying to progress, we're trying to do something, build something, they're not going to lead us in the right direction, etc, etc, etc. So you have directors going, approaching their shareholders along those sort of lines. But then you've also got the other dynamic as well from the bidder company trying to persuade the shareholders as well, we can up profits, we can up dividends and so on. And from the shareholders' perspective, who do you listen to? I think the questions come from, one, what is the previous history of that bidder company? Are they who they say they are? Can they walk the walk as well as talk the talk? And also you have the element from previous history of that target company. Has that target company been meeting its targets? Have they been saying what they preached? So you can see those are the dynamics of a hostile takeover, and that's why it's a bit more interesting to have a hostile takeover. And you can imagine how that affects the stock market, because that's ultimately what it boils down to. But at the end of the day, what talks the most is this money. Whether you're having a friendly takeover or hostile takeover, it's only money that talks. Share price of the target company in particular tends to rise. And it gets so bad that even before the takeover, just upon the release of news alone, so it can be complete Chinese whispers, it can be complete rumors, and the share price will rise, like significantly. That's how impactful takeovers can be. And the reason why the share price tends to rise is because that bidder company views that target company as very valuable, and therefore they strongly believe that there is a great deal of value in that bidder company. So that's what bumps up the share price of the target company. Now the bidder company will be particularly interested in that target company because of two reasons. One, it reduces costs, and slash or two, it increases revenues. From a cost perspective, this could significantly reduce Apple's cost if Apple took over Disney, because in terms of advertisement, that's one example. So instead of like having to pay, I don't know, different channels to advertise on their Apple products on their channel, they wouldn't have to pay Disney because they practically own Disney. So Disney would do it free of charge without charging Apple. So that's a good example of how they could have reduced costs. How they could have increased revenues, increased sales is along that sort of line as well. So maybe they could have had like produced a manufactured sort of child-friendly Apple product that's specifically designated for children. And because it's advertised on the Disney Channel, it's the perfect platform, get the best of both worlds. So that's a good example of how a takeover can benefit a company in terms of increasing revenue, but also reducing costs as well. Now another cheeky part in terms of a takeover is where you have a bidder company trying to buy the target company, and the way that they can reduce their costs is by combining both forces, but basically laying people off. Now a takeover can be a good cover for laying people off, because you're joining forces. The news of the takeover far outweighs the news of firing people, basically. So if company A tried to take over company B, then they could join forces, their sales teams and their production team can be in the same building. Therefore, they wouldn't need two different sites or maybe multiple different sites. And hence, they would unfortunately be able to fire people. And you can also get bidder companies that are from the private sector trying to buy a target company in the public sector, in the stock market. That's the ideal scenario for a shareholder that's of a target company. The reason being is because that private company is willing to pay above the odds for complete ownership of that target company. So basically, you can do negotiations. On the release of any takeover news, the general gist is that the shareholders of the target company will be happy because the share price tends to rise due to the overvaluation of that target company. And like anything in life that goes up, it must come back down, back to reality. So share price eventually, after a while, goes back down to where it was again, and it starts to settle out as the news is basically dying down. You guys now know what a takeover is and why it basically makes the investors mouth water when they hear that their company is being taken over by another bidder company. And that's the end of my video, guys. Now before you beautiful people can keep on doing whatever you're going to do for the rest of the day, you know what to do. Like, subscribe and share. Yes, learning balance. Whoa, bye.